How's it going, Eliminators? Today, I'm going to be showing you a quick little trick that'll hopefully get your lawnmower back up and running if you're having a cable adjustment issue. So let's get right into it. So with springtime upon us, we are starting to work on all kinds of push mowers. And a lot of these push mowers have the one cable design that just goes up to the handle right here to disengage the blade brake. So when you engage that lever, it simply disengages the blade brake on the flywheel there, and it also disengages the engine's kill switch. So when you let off of that handle, it engages the kill switch, and that's what cuts the spark by grounding the coil. Now, something that's common on a lot of these single control mowers is that when you go to engage this handle here, it doesn't release the kill switch on your engine. And what I find is that the little metal plate here sometimes gets bent, maybe from someone running into something. Basically what it does is when you go to engage your handle up top, it doesn't allow the kill switch to disengage. Now, in order to get this cable to disengage the kill switch, you have to shorten this cable up. And one of the little hacks that I see is people actually take this cable here and physically put a knot in this cable to shorten it up. But the problem is, over time, that will cause the cable to fray and your cable will eventually break because there's going to be more pressure where that knot has been tied. So what I'm going to show you is how to basically shorten up your cable so that it engages the arm here tighter. And to do that, we're just going to be coming down to these little caps here on the ends of the cable. So we're back in the shop now, and I have the cable here. We have the little plastic end, and this is what pops into the little metal tab that they have. And then here's your cable that goes to the control on the engine side. And then you have one of these ends up on the lever side on your handle. So what a lot of people don't know is that these caps unthread. And when you unthread these caps, it's actually going to shorten your cable because it's going to lengthen the cable housing. And you can simply just take this, and you're going to see here that this will actually start to unthread itself. And you'll get quite a few turns off of it until the cap comes off completely. So you guys are gonna see that it almost looks like it's threaded, but it's just a plastic thread inside of there. But what you can do is get up to, I'd say, an extra about maybe half of an inch just on one end, and then you could do the same at the other end of the cable as well. So they actually give you quite a bit of adjustment on these cables. And this is just a little trick that I wanted to share with you guys so that instead of going and bending your metal brackets or tying knots in your cables, you can simply make an adjustment right on the end of the cable there. So if you find yourself pulling and pulling on the pull cord, but your engine simply doesn't start because there's no spark on your engine because the kill switch simply isn't disengaging, all you have to do is go up to your cable and simply make that slight little adjustment. And like I said, you can probably get up to about a half an inch on either end. Sometimes you're going to have a different style cap on the other end that won't allow you to have that adjustability. But normally, 9 times out of 10, there's always going to be one end that will allow you to have some adjustability. It's pretty much the same thing when you're adjusting a brake lever on a bicycle. You simply thread out the little end and it lengthens the outer casing, which is going to in turn shorten your cable. You can go ahead and reinstall your cable if you did remove it, but a lot of times on these machines, all you have to do is disconnect this little plastic piece here, go ahead and disconnect your cable, and then you can make this adjustment right there on the lawnmower. You can go ahead and reconnect your cable and your machine should fire back up again. So just a quick little video this weekend, but I wanted to share that little trick that not too many people know about because you might find that it helps you out if you ever run into this issue. If you guys enjoyed the video, think about leaving me a thumbs up. You know, it really helps me out. You can click here to subscribe and click over here to watch one of my previous videos. I upload every single week, so be sure to stop on by next week, check channel out for new content. And as always, guys, thanks for watching.